This video is the final part in a six-part series on matrices and matrix math. None of these videos are for any particular program. This final video is over the inverse of a matrix. The inverse of a number is where you essentially flip the number upside down. So, for example, if your number is 12, then its inverse is going to be 1 over 12. If your number is 3 halves, its inverse is 2 thirds. One of the most important characteristics of an inverse is that when you multiply it by its original, you always return the number 1. Inverses are extremely useful when you're working with complicated calculations. Here we have the equation AB plus C squared plus D over 3 halves. This can be a lot easier to read if you simply use an inverse. When you're calculating with matrices, you aren't able to divide at all, so you need to rather multiply by the matrix's inverse. Calculating the inverse of a matrix by hand is difficult, but it is possible. You need to use the characteristic of an inverse, that by multiplying an inverse by its original, you will get back the number 1 for a single value, or the identity matrix if you're working with matrices. I'm going to be using a very simple example that I got from the website purplemath.com. This example is unique in the fact that they're using an entirely integer matrix, which means that not only is the original matrix completely filled with integers, but its resulting inverse is as well. This makes it much easier to calculate by hand. Now, I'm not expecting you to understand how to calculate the inverse of any matrix after watching this video, but it does help that when you're using a tool on a computer or a program to understand the basics of how the computer works. Or in this case, if you're going to be using Excel to calculate the inverse of a matrix, it helps to have a general idea how the matrix would be calculated by hand. So for this example, the matrix they give is called matrix A. Now I need an inverse that when it's multiplied by A, it will return the 3x3 identity matrix, which is I. To set this up, it helps to put the two together. So if I create a double wide matrix and put the identity matrix on the other side, this will help me perform the calculations to generate the inverse of this matrix. Now to calculate this, you have to perform the calculations on each row of this matrix to make the left-hand side turn into the identity matrix that's currently on the right. This situation is fairly simple since these rows are pretty close in number. So to start with, I'm going to change row number 2. So for row number 2, I'm going to alter that by subtracting row number 1 from it. So if I go down here, and I still have row number 1 the same, and row number 3 the same, except row number 2 is now 0, and then 4 minus 3 is 1, 3 minus 3 is 0, and that becomes a negative 1, that remains 1, and that remains 0. I can change row number 3 by doing the same thing that I just did to row number 2. I'm just going to erase what's currently in row number 3, and row number 3 minus row number 1, so that becomes a 0, a 0, and a 1. That's a negative 1, a 0, and a 1. Now finally, I need to change the first row because I have these bottom two rows on the left side the same as the identity matrix was previously. So to change the first row, first I'm going to subtract 3 times the second row. I'm going to keep my second and third row the same. So 0 times negative 3 is still 0, so that remains a 1. Then this becomes a 0, because I'm subtracting negative 3 from it, and that remains a 3. Negative 3 times negative 1 is 3. That becomes 4. That becomes a negative 3, and this remains a 0. Now I need to do the same thing with row number 3. So I need to multiply row number 3 by negative 3, and then subtract row number 1 from it. So that becomes a 1. That stays 0. And this, subtract 3 from 3, is 0. Now here, 4 plus 3 is 7. That remains a negative 3, and that becomes negative 3. Now this right here, this matrix, that's 7, negative 3, negative 3, negative 1, 1, 0, negative 1, 0, 1. This is the inverse of my original matrix A. One way to test this is to multiply A times A to the inverse and see if we get back the identity matrix. Now, if we step through this, for the first spot here, we multiply the first row here times the first column here. So 7 minus 3 minus 3 becomes 1. And then negative 3 plus 3 is 0. And then negative 3 plus 0 plus 3 is 0. Second row is 7 minus 4 minus 3, that's 0. Negative 3 plus 4 is 1. And then negative 3 plus 0 plus 3 is 0. 7 minus 3 minus 4 is 0. Negative 3 plus 3 plus 0 is 0. And then negative 3 plus 0 plus 4 is 1. And we've returned our identity matrix. So this has been confirmed to be the inverse of this matrix here. So essentially what we did here is we may have multiplied A by its inverse, but you can also think of this as us having divided A by itself. So later on when you're working with matrices and you need to divide the two matrices, don't forget the inverse. Because if I had a matrix B that I had to divide A into, I would instead do B times the inverse of A.